State, being able to go out here and do something with your fellow brothers beside me. Big shout out to Caleb for staying composed, defense for shutting it out, our O line for going ahead and taking away, and even Marshawn even opened up for the pass game. He had like 10 yards of carry. Big shout out to him.
I asked Caleb how his trust in you has grown from last year, and he said, I mean, a lot of time with you off the field itself. How does that translate to on the field?
The time we spent off the field, I feel like I actually, last year, it was a little rocky, you know, just coming in transfer portal. We were just such in a hurry. We didn't get a lot of time to spend with each other. This year, we get time just off the field and, like, go ahead. We watch football on Sundays, order some wings and stuff. And it really translates. And then you go ahead and put in the work that we get after practice with all the other receivers. And that's why all the receivers are able to go and dominate. And I feel as though that this group has enough one in the nation. Goes ahead and makes sure that he can get the right reads. He knows who to hold on to the ball, bail out the pocket, let it go. And for that, as a receiver, it enables me to go ahead and, like, play's not dead. Let me get open. Let me find a way. Let me get in his vision. And I'm happy that he found me tonight.
Brenden, you know, obviously, you know, you're coming back home. Played your high school ball at Hamilton. Just sort of take me back to your high school days and just how important Hamilton was to your development to where you are now.
Man, my Hamilton Huskies. I wanted to go to a game yesterday. Couldn't go. I had to focus on this one ahead of us. But sure, shout out to my Hamilton Huskies. Shout out to Coach Zdebski, Coach Tuck. I know that some of them guys were here tonight. I'm thankful for them. That development aspect of it. There was a lot of days. We went through 2-a-days, 2 workouts a day. I was lifting. Going ahead, they put me in track because a lot of people believed I wasn't fast enough. I love proving people wrong. So just being out there and, like, having that development and having that coaching style from them and that back support enabled me to be the person I am today. It's our first road game. We took a punch to the face and we punched it back. Came out on top, and that's all that matters. We got the dub, we're going home happy. 12 hours of excitement, and then we're ready for, you know, this person.
What ways do you feel you're better as a receiver this year? In what ways do you feel you're a better receiver this year?
I would have to say that more what I said in the beginning of the season. I've been practicing consistently within practice. I've been making sure that my outside, everything that's going on outside aligns with I have inside, because if you have a lot of stuff going out, going around, like doing too much outside of the game of football, then it's going to show up in the game of football inside the game.
This was your first road game, like you mentioned. What was the environment like out there, and what did it feel like?
Man, it was amazing. I mean, what was it, like the homecoming? The parents' weekend?
I think it was parents' weekend. Yeah.
Man, so just to come home to that and see, boy, it was like 50, 60,000. Man, it was amazing to see the atmosphere in Arizona. I'm blessed and fortunate to play for that huge crowd, especially my family, my friends. I'm fortunate. Thank you.
Did it cause any issues? It seemed like there were some pre-snap issues where you guys were, like, not getting the play in, or it just wasn't able to get off cleanly.
We practiced with loud noises all week. So anything that we had was just mental errors. That's on our part. We're going to go ahead and fix it and be ready for the next one.
The last time we played against Stanford, the offense was flawless early on. We were a little disjointed here tonight. What was the conversation, kind of messaging on the sideline?
I mean, adversity struck us. It struck us hard, and we went ahead and took care of it, and that's all that matters. We bounced back. We got things that we need to get right, and you guys saw the scoreboard at the end of the game, 42. That's all that matters.
Chris, hopping on that fourth down touchdown, what did you see, what Lincoln see?
My first touchdown?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so all week
The second one, you were wide open there, and he kind of made you work for it on the sidelines. What were you thinking with the ball in the air?
Oh, man, all I was thinking is don't run too fast. We're going to step out of bounds. I had to slow down really and focus, try to get both my feet in. But as you all can see, Caleb, his vision is amazing. He's going to find you.
Brenden, how come you've become such Caleb's favorite scramble target? When he goes scrambling, it seems like you're the guy most often that he finds.
Yeah. I don't think I'm just his favorite. I think that all of us are working to get open, and I was just fortunate enough to be open on most of those plays. I think anybody can go ahead and take over at any given moment.
Do you feel like you've learned something from playing with him the last year of when he starts, you know, creating magic in the pocket, that to be able to find those ideal pockets for him?
For sure, for sure. I know it. I feel like that goes back to just what we're doing off the field, that chemistry. And then with that chemistry, it allows me like to know what he's thinking, know where he wants me, and then he finds me on the scrambles.
Did you do one more?
You said